moving along to face temptation's all. Where could I go? So dear, comfort I get from God's own word. Well, yet when I face the chilling hand of death, where could I go but to the Lord? Where we sing are kind. Well, I love them, everyone. Oh, we get along in sweet accord. Well, but when my soul needs manna from above, oh, where could I go but to the Lord? Oh, when we sing, where could I go? Seeking a refuge for my soul. Well, needing a friend. Where could I go but to? One more time. Where could I go? Seeking a refuge for my soul, needing a friend, oh, to help me in the end. Where could I go but to the Lord? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, well, my burdens, they rolled away. Well, my burdens, they rolled away. Oh, I sat the feet of Jesus. He healed all my diseases. And my burdens, they rolled away. Oh, my burdens, they rolled away. Well, my burdens, they rolled away. Oh, my was at the feet of Jesus. He healed all my diseases, and my burdens, they rolled away. I said, my burdens, they rolled away. I was at the feet, was at the feet of Jesus. He healed all my diseases, and my burdens, they rolled away. Oh, my burdens, they rolled away. My burdens, they sisters, are you free this morning? Then sing it. Come on, sisters. Come on, brothers. We sang my burden, my burdens. Oh, let's hear the brothers now. Oh, was at the feet. And my burdens, they rose. Everybody. Oh, yes, my burdens, my burdens. Oh, sing like you mean it. Oh, was at the feet. He healed all my diseases, and my burdens they rolled up. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I like the old time singing, shouting. I like the old time way. I like the old time singing, shouting, preaching, praying. I like the old time way. Oh, I talk about my Savior everywhere I go. Oh, everywhere I go. Everywhere I go. Talk about my Savior everywhere I go. Joy. Oh, my. I like the old time singing, shouting. I like the old time way. I like the old time singing, shouting, preaching, praying. I like the old time way. Well, I'll sing about my Savior everywhere I go, everywhere I go, everywhere I go. I'll sing about my Savior everywhere I go. For there's joy, joy in my soul. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us pray, amen. Father, we thank you this morning. We can be found in your presence, Lord. Lord, my burdens rolled away. I've not come in here with burdens this morning. Lord, Tuesday we were told by the minister to leave our burdens, Lord. So we left them at Mangere Hall, Lord God. And we walked in here this morning with no burdens, Lord. No trials, Father. Lord, nothing to bind me, God. I am free to worship you this morning, Lord. I am free to praise you this morning. Lord, I can raise my hands, Father. Lord, I can shout this morning, God. Oh, I can clap my hands, God. I can say hallelujah because I'm free this morning, Lord. And this morning, God, I command my hands to praise the Lord. I command my feet to praise the Lord. I command my lips to praise the Lord. I command myself to praise the Lord, oh God. And that's what we are here for this morning, Lord. I'm here to praise the Lord. I don't care who's next to me. I don't care who doesn't want to worship. I don't care who's sad. I don't care who's down. I don't care who's dead, Lord. But me, God, I am here to worship you, Lord. I am here to praise you. Lord, I'm here to tell the devil he's a liar this morning, God. I'm here to let the devil know, Father, that I'm on victory ground this morning. So we thank you, Father. I'm on victory ground this morning. Give you praise, Father. Give you glory, Lord. Bless us this morning. Lord, sanctify the building. As your believers are sanctified, Your minister sanctified. Your word is anointed, Lord. Sanctify us, Lord, as we under expectation, God. Lord, I'm not here for just another Sunday meeting. I am not here, Father God, just to go through the motions, Lord. I'm here, Lord God, because I want to enjoy you, Father. I want to enjoy my salvation. I'm here because I enjoy serving you, Lord. I enjoy worshiping you, Father. So, Lord God, have your way. Commit this meeting into your hands in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Give the Lord a hand of praise. Amen, amen, amen. Amen, amen. Let's give the fathers a hand, shall we? Hello, brown boys. Give your dad a better hand, man. Praise the Lord, amen. Amen, amen, amen. God bless you this morning. Good to be in church, amen. God bless you. Good to be in the house of the Lord this morning. Amen. Maybe you want to turn around and shake your neighbor's hand and say, God bless you, brother. God bless you, sister. Go out of your way. Amen. We want to welcome Brother Ralph. Welcome everybody that's listening. God bless you. Welcome. God bless you. Go out of your way. Say good morning, brother. Good morning, sister. Welcome in the house of the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. We're going to have church this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. We're going to have church today. Oh, every devil is under our feet. Amen. Every nun praise devil. We are to worship God. We are to praise God. We are to give him the glory. We are to give him the honor. We are to let the devil know he's a liar. Brother Branham said he's under my feet. He's under my feet. Oh, hallelujah. I command. I command my hands to praise the Lord. Don't need me this morning. Command your hands. Command. my feet. I command my feet. Oh, to praise the Lord. I command my feet. I command my feet. Oh, I love it. What about the mouth? I command my mouth. I command my mouth. Oh, just one more. Hands, I command my hand. Hands, feet, mouth. Hands, feet, mouth. Hey. I love it. Hands, I command my hand. The feet and the mouth. I command my hands, feet, mouth. I command my hands, feet, mouth. One more promise. I command my hands, feet, mouth. I command my hands, feet, mouth. Oh, I command my hands, feet, mouth. The Lord. Oh, give him a shout, amen. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Now, this is for all those that never shouted on the first shout. Give him a shout. Amen. Oh, my. Amen. Could have been church. Brothers and sisters, we are free. The devil is a liar. We have no problems. We have no trials. We are on our way to heaven. We are free. And it's good to be free. And I like the quote we heard in the week. The weakest of Christians. The weakest. You say you're weak? Where's the devil? Under your feet, brother. I command my feet to praise the Lord. I command my feet to praise the Lord. I command my feet to pray. Come on. Stamp that devil to pray. Stamp that devil. Come on. I command my feet. Come on, let's stamp that devil. Every devil. That devil that troubled you. That devil that's burdened you. That devil that's given you problems. Every devil. Every devil, brother. Every devil. Every devil. I command my feet. Every devil. Come on, church. I challenge you. Every devil. All those devils. Devils of hell. Devils of hell. Under my feet. Under my feet. Under my feet. Come on, stamp those feet. I command my feet. Yes, sir. Every devil. Every devil. Every devil. What about you young people? Every devil. Every devil. Every devil. Under my feet. Under my feet. Under my feet. Oh. Feet. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Oh, feet, you've got to praise the Lord. Feet, feet, you've got to praise the Lord. Feet, church, every devil, I command my feet. Oh, to praise the Lord. I command my feet. I command my feet. Yes, sir. We're free this morning. Church, we are free. We are free this morning. I command my mouth. We are free this morning. Satan, you're a liar. The devil's a liar. Every sickness, every every problem to praise the oh heaven. Every devil, brother, every devil is under our feet this morning. Every backsliding devil, every failing devil, every lying devil, every lust devil, every alcohol devil, every devil, it's under my feet. Oh, hallelujah. Church, we are free. Where's the devil? He's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Do the enemy's cap. Everybody, Brother Sione, I'm jumping for you. I'm jumping for you. It's under my feet. He's under my. This is for Brother Sione. Hey, Satan. This is for Jeremiah. Jeremiah is under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. He's under my feet. For Malachi. For Malachi. He's under my feet. He's under my. I've got a feeling everything's gonna be alright. Church, he's troubled me enough. This devil has bothered me enough. This devil has troubled me enough. I'm here to let the devil know he's under my feet. The realm is under my feet. He's under my feet. And this is not emotion. This is not a workup. This is reality. This is reality. This is reality. I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. I'm free. I'm free. Oh, it's under my feet. It's under my feet. It's under my feet. Okay, brother, come in. He's under my feet. Satan is. Oh, how I love Jesus. God, I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. Thank you for setting me free, Lord. Thank you for delivering me, Lord, from mind battles, complexes, and issues. And thank you for setting me free, Lord. God, I'm here to enjoy you this morning. I'm here to say, I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. To me, he it's so wonderful. Sing it now to me. Sister Max, where's Max? Where's Sister Max? Oh my. Let's sing it one more time. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh my, you can sit, you can stand. As long as you maintain this presence, you can do whatever you want to do. Just maintain this atmosphere. I believe this morning things are going to happen. I believe this morning things are going to take place. I believe that this morning.
Take your seats, or you can stand along and sing and worship the Lord with me. He deserves all glory. All glory belongs to you, Lord.
How can I say thanks for all the things you have done for me, things so undeserved, yet you give to prove your love for me, and the voices of a million angels could not express my gratitude. Everything that I am and ever hope to be, I owe it all to you, to God be the glory.
What a beautiful presence. What a beautiful atmosphere. Oh, my. You know, there's a song that the outreach team sang. Amen. And we don't want to disturb the presence of the Lord. So maybe if the team can just come up quickly and quietly. And somebody says, "You unravel me like a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from mine enemies until all my fear."
To all my friends. free of all fear. All fear. I'm a son of God. I'm a daughter of God. He made a change in my life. We were all slaves to fear. We were all slaves to doubt. But Christ set us free. And if you are not free yet, you can't go free this morning. I refuse to be a slave. I heard the Jubilee trumpet. I refuse. I am no longer serving my master. I'm free. I'm going back to my inheritance. Hallelujah. If you're not free this morning, you can't go free. You can this morning throw down your hope. And you can this morning say to that slave master, no longer are you holding me captive. No longer am I a slave to sin or to fear. I am free. I challenge each one of you this morning. If you are not free, you're a slave. If you are not free, then you are a slave. That's where the enemy wants to hold you, as a slave. But this morning we heard the song. We heard the Jubilee trumpet sound out. I am no longer a slave to fear. I'm no longer a slave to sin. I am no longer a slave to self. I am free. He's under my feet. Fear is under my feet. Sin is under my feet. The order of fear and sin is under my feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Sing it, sing it. upset things. But he's a liar. He's a devil. So he's going to do everything in his power to hinder the Holy Ghost this morning. But he's a liar. Amen. He set us free. Hallelujah. And we are sons and daughters of God. And whom the Son has set free.
Yes,
you are free indeed. Hallelujah. You are free indeed. So we want to thank God. You may be seated. Hallelujah. Thank you. Hallelujah. My. What a presence. What a time. Hallelujah. Brother, God never fails. God never fails. Amen. God is always on the scene. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So this morning, amen, we're just so happy to be in the presence of God. This morning, if you have a special need in your heart, you can just slip up your hand right now as we can pray. Any need, you've got a burden, you've got a need. You've got a need this morning. Maybe you're not on the place where you ought to be. Maybe your fountain has run dry. Maybe the lifeline has been cut or severed. But God this morning can reconnect that lifeline, that sap line. Because if you're not abiding in Him, you're going to run dry. And that's what the enemy wants to do. He wants to cut the lifeline. That you might become all twisted. And all gnarly. And all mean. Because if that lifeline runs dry, you become like a cactus. Loving Father, you've seen the hands this morning. We really don't know what to do this morning. We don't know which way we ought to go this morning. But Lord, you are in control. And we want to pray for every hand that's raised here this morning. Loving Father, that thou wilt take over this morning. If you want me to preach, I'll preach, Lord. If you want me to say nothing, I'll say nothing. But we want to give you this morning, loving Father, the liberty to do whatever thou wantest to do. There's needs here this morning. Maybe some unspoken request this morning. But a hand has been raised, Lord. And under that hand there's a need. I would ask of you this morning, loving Father, that maybe somewhere, Lord, on internet, somewhere in India, maybe, my God, in Las Vegas, maybe in Australia, wherever your people this morning are listening to us, maybe there's a need there this morning. And we pray, Father God, that you will this morning meet that need. You hear the cry of the heart this morning. I pray this morning for our young people. Pray this morning for moms and dads and those that are not here this morning in church. We ask of you this morning, loving Father, that you would meet each one. That Lord, before this day is over, this morning is over, that something would have happened in their hearts and in their souls, that they will never be the same again. Have your way this morning, Lord. Whatever we're going to do, whatever you want us to do, Lord, will you grant direction this morning? We're so glad that we can testify this morning. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I'm no longer a slave to sin. I'm a child of God. I've gone back to my inheritance, Lord. I've gone back to my Father. I've gone back to what He has ordained us to have. Have your way this morning. Bless your people this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. 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 Oh my. My. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Of God, I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. Oh, can we see it? I'm no longer. I am a child. You may walk out of here this morning, turn a deaf ear to the sounding of the jubilee trumpet. You can walk out of here this morning while the angel has stirred the water, and you will continue in your sin, and you will continue in your life of defeat. You can turn a deaf ear this morning and don't heed the warning, and you can walk out of here this morning worse than the way you come in this morning. And I want to tell you this morning, church, the Bible says, when you refuse to hear the jubilee trumpet, then the master takes you to the temple post, and he would bore your ear, put a hole in your ear, signifying that you will never ever be able to hear. You will hear it, but you won't be able to respond, because you are declaring this morning, I love my master. I love the defeatist life I'm living. I love the sin I am in. I love what I'm doing. That's what you are declaring this morning. If you don't heed the jubilee trumpet. And never ever, the Bible says, no matter how many times that jubilee trumpet sounds, you will never be able to go free. You'll be a cleaner of the outhouse. You will be a garbage can for the devil if you don't hear the jubilee trumpet this morning. Hallelujah. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child. It's a terrible thing to be a slave of fear. It's a terrible thing. The Bible says when the night is upon you, then you wish for the day. That's what fear does. Can't sleep at night because of fear. Then you wish for the morning to break. And when the morning is upon you, then you wish for the night. That's what fear does. And when fear comes upon you, it paralyzes your faith. Can't believe God. That's what fear does. But you can go free. This morning, you can break from this morning, the shackles of fear, the shackles of sin, can break free this morning. And your life after today will never be the same again once you break free. You can say this morning to the devil, enough is enough. You can say to the devil this morning, enough is enough. Hallelujah. I've been your slave for too long. I've been your lackey. I've been your boy. I've been your dudman. But this morning, I've heard the voice of God calling out. You can go free. You can be delivered. Can be healed this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hey. Oh, I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. God said, when the king was going to make war, Ahab, and he was fearful, how am I going to overcome? How am I going to have victory? Then the prophet of God sent him a message, told him, going to use the young men. You are going to use the young men that's going to raise up and conquer. You're going to use the young men. When David desired a drink of water from the wells of Bethlehem, and Israel, David's men was in a cave, and David expressed his longing, if I might have some water from the well of Bethlehem. Three men, Bible called them brave, valiant men. The Bible says they fought the ranks of enemy to get water for an earthly king. The Bible says they fought through ranks of enemy, and they came back with the water. And David, when he got the water, he says, these men put their lives in jeopardy because of my desire for a glass of water. I can't drink this water at the cost of these men's lives. And history says that the swords of those men were almost like glued to their hands for a desire of an earthly king. I challenge young men, can you stand for your king? They knew David was coming in power. They knew David was in a cave. David was fleeing from the Saul and the Philistines. But they knew that the anointing of God was on David. They knew. And I tell you, they gave their lives. They didn't spare their lives, because they wanted to please David. May God find some men in this church, some young men that's willing, at the cost of their lives. Because the Bible does say, Isaiah, if you seek to save your life, you're going to lose it. But if you lose your life for my sake and the gospel, you will save it. Hallelujah. I lost my life in 1960 because I knew I forsook everything. I walked away from family and lands and inheritance to be found a valiant soldier for my King, for my Lord. And I challenge you this morning. Often I challenge you. Gershon, I challenge you. Masui, I challenge you. The Brown boys, I challenge you. Caleb, I challenge you. I challenge you, Jerry. I challenge you, Malachi. I challenge you. Give your lives to Him. Give your lives to Him. You lose your life for my sake in the gospel, you will find it. You will save it. And if you want to save your life, then you're going to lose it in any case. I challenge you. Hallelujah. Who will stand for Him? Who will stand? Who will draw your sword this morning and declare, I'm taking a stand this morning? Who will declare this morning, God used the young men to overcome the enemy? God used the young men. When you read the history of David and the men that stood with him, the Bible spoke about the history of these men. David had some special men with him. Special men. Bible says those men, brother, one of them killed 300 Philistines. One of them jumped into a pit during winter, killed a lion. And they were ordinary men, but they were valiant. They were Gideons. They were men. Hallelujah. That stood and took a sign for the gospel of Christ. I challenge you this morning, young men, sisters has got their place, but young men, I challenge you this morning, will you take a stand for Him? Will you take a stand for Him? You can never lose. You will never lose when you stand with Him. You will never ever be a defeated if you stand for Him. So I challenge the church. Challenge some mothers this morning. How's your prayer life? How's your dedication for your children? How is it? Can God find some to send Wesley's amongst us, our mothers? Come to send Wesley's. Raise 16 children. And with all the work she did, she still had time to pray. And through her prayers, we got Charles Wesley's. We got John Wesley's. Mighty men that God used because of one wife, one mother. Mother, I challenge the mothers this morning. Challenge the mothers this morning. Can God find you faithful and true and dedicated, consecrated for your family? Hallelujah. I want to read one quote. Preach on a little subject this morning. We prepare every day like today is the day. We prepare every day like today is the day. What are you preparing for? What is your dreams? What is your goal? What are you preparing for? What are you preparing for? Good life? Your future? That's good. Your goals? You heard me saying many times, the will to win means nothing without the will to prepare. The will to win means nothing without the will to prepare. You want to be the best in your field? You won't get there without preparing. You want to be the best musician? You won't get there without practicing. You want to be the best singer? You won't get there without preparing. You will never make the rapture without preparing. You will never live a godly and an overcoming life unless you have the will to prepare. Hallelujah. We prepare every day like today is the day. Hallelujah. I just want to read a quote. America failed to hear and to heed the warning. Brother Branham talks about Japan. Talks about Pearl Harbor. And he says, in the sudden secret going away of the church. He said, I was reading an article some time ago of the sudden attack on Pearl Harbor. He says, that wasn't exactly an any unknown attack. They had already been warned that the Japs were going to do that. But the sad part was, they ignored the warning. They ignored the warning. They had seen the signs and the Japanese army assembling themselves together and the big ships being loaded with ammunition, and the threat was in the air. And they were just exactly in line for the invasion, but they ignored it. Maybe I'm talking about somebody here this morning.
Maybe God is talking to somebody here this morning. Seeing the signs. Signs in the sky. He's telling us. We read it in the newspapers. We read it in the scriptures. But we ignore it. We ignore it. But you ignoring it, it's not going to stop it from happening. You putting your head in the sand is not going to stop it from happening. You putting your head in your sand and seeing your children going lost, it's not going to stop it. That's the way it is today with the church. The church is in line of judgment, but they are ignoring the coming of the Lord. Brother Bam says you can't blame him. They said when it was noised abroad around Pearl Harbor that the Japs were going to attack, and they had their big fleet had set out in the waters of the sea and was moving slowly but steadily towards Pearl Harbor, that they only laughed at it and said, "Oh, nonsense. You gloom builders." You might think that morning of me. I'm a gloom builder. You might think this morning of me that I'm trying to spoil your fun. You might think this morning of me, Sunday after Sunday, coming here and warning you, telling you, watch, pray. And you might think the worst of me, but I don't mind. You might call me a gloom builder. You might call me a worrywart. And all I think about is trouble. Maybe that's your thoughts. Doesn't matter what you think about me, or what I'm reading, or what I'm saying, or what I'm preaching. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. One of these mornings, church, between 6 and 9, we are leaving here. And I'm warning you this morning, it's going to happen. Rapture's going to take place. And on the night, just before the great attack, there was a big, great dance and a big party given in Pearl Harbor itself. And no matter how much they tried to say that the Japs were coming, they still would not take warning. Let's just look on them for a few minutes. The prophet of God said there's a little radio bulletin goes out. And a little piece in the corner of the paper about like a healing campaign would be advertised, just a small piece, that the Japs were on their road in the waters of the sea. A great fleet was headed that way. Nonsense, they say. We don't believe in no such stuff as that. What are you trying to scare us about? What are you trying to scare us about? You miss the rapture. Torment will be that you know what's going to happen next. That's the torment. That we know the truth. We know about the tribulation. We know about the beast. We know about the plagues. That's the tragedy. We know it. Be prepared to miss the rapture. Prophet of God said, "Man, pull my skin off. Strip my skin. Pour sulfuric acid into those wounds. But don't let me miss the rapture."
don't let me miss the rapture. Don't let me miss the rapture. We don't believe in such stuff as that. What are you trying to scare us about? And then we find, getting closer to the night, I can see at the home place, instead of them preparing to get out of the city, this is why the young girls were all putting on their new frocks and so forth. This is the prophet talking. They were going down to this great big jubilee. And also the officers of the army were just busy writing little passes so that the soldiers could all attend this party, and judgment was on the horizon. Big drunken parties. Trucks were roaring and humming, bringing in the best of beer and the wine and stuff for this party. And all the time, the Japanese fleet was on its road there, and they failed to hear the warning. Failed to hear the warning. Right now, the world is trembling and shaking, and the world is not knowing what's happening or what's going to happen next. But are we worried? Are we concerned? Don't think so. We were concerned this morning there will be an altar full of people here this morning. We are concerned over that, brother, then you would have been here this morning on your knees crying out, God have mercy. God have mercy. If you really believe what the prophet of God came to tell us, if you really believe the message of the hour and the judgments, and this earth is going to be awash with flames of fire, then we would have been here this morning crying out to God while the angel of God was stirring the waters. But you see, our senses have become so dulled. The pressures of life. And doing this and doing that. Listen, I'm not saying you're a Christian. That you're not a Christian. I'm not saying that. All I'm saying this morning, that the creepers of this life is choking the life out of you. They failed to hear the warning. But we, I believe there's some here this morning, but we are looking for that great sudden, that secret sudden appearing of the Lord. For there is something in the air. As much as there's judgment in the air, there's also hope for the believer. Something in the air, a message of the Holy Spirit that's telling us that the coming is at hand. Holy Spirit, telling you, nudging you, pushing you, an inward life telling you, there's something in the air. Get ready. Get ready. Get prayed up. Get ready. Hallelujah. Then the next morning, when the man on the post of duty and the airplane signal watching and so forth had been up all night drunk and running around with those women and so forth, he was so drowsy and upset the next morning from the big party until they were caught asleep on the job. And I'm afraid that is going to be likewise at the coming of the Lord. The church is so took up and drunken with the cares of this world. Though they are going to be asleep at the post of duty at the coming of the Lord. Hallelujah. You know, 1 Peter 1, 1 Peter 5, 8, and 1 Thessalonians 5, 1 to 8. says, be watchful. Be sober. Be sober. 1 Peter 5, 8 to 11. Be sober. Be vigilant. And that means keenly watchful to detect danger. Like a vigilant sentry, ever awake and alert. Be sober. Be vigilant. And it also means sleeplessly, sleeplessly watchful. Don't sleep. You're watchful. You're vigilant. You're sober. Because the coming of the Lord is at hand. Watchful. We need to be watchful against the subtle and malicious designs of Satan. We've got to be watchful. And Peter is crying out here, awake and keep awake. Sleep no more. And Peter could speak that way because Jesus told him, Simon, Simon, Satan is earnestly desiring to have you to sift you like wheat. And Peter was not watchful enough. That's why Peter, now converted, remembers what he has gone through. Now he's warning the body. Says, keep awake. Be sober. Don't be like me. I was asleep. And I wasn't sober enough for the adversary, the enemy, to come in and twist my mind that I betrayed him. Said I didn't know him. Now Peter is saying, stay vigilant. He says, because your adversary, the lion is the enemy is like a roaring lion to swallow up both soul and body. Because that is what the devil wants to do. To swallow you up. Hallelujah. And I want to say this morning, unless a man is sober in body and in mind, he will not be watchful either over himself or others or against the snares of sin. Oh my. Peter saying, if you don't watch and be on your guard, he says, you are liable to be ensnared by every sin and temptation. Then Peter screams out, church, watch and be ye mindful. Or remember, he says, watch with diligence, keeping a good lookout, minding and observing everything that the enemy is presenting to you, because he's cunning. Gotta watch. So Brother Bram says, and then over the city flew the planes, and the bombs dropped, and they were just battered out of that city to the ground. Why? Because they wouldn't take heed to the warning. They wouldn't take heed to the warning. My prayer this morning is, church, that we might take heed this morning to the warning. Take heed this morning what the Holy Ghost is trying to tell us this morning. Take heed. Take heed. Be sober. Be alert. Be watchful. Because your adversary, the devil, your adversary, is going around like a roaring lion, seeking whom he might devour and destroy. God, help us this morning. God, help us. That we'll be watchful and prayerful. And this morning, your decision. What you want to do. Be the same. Just coming and going, just barely surviving. Or are you willing this morning? All of me, Lord. I've been fooling around too long. But this morning, I want to surrender my all. To surrender my life. Maybe some mother, some dad will say, for my family's sake. For my family's sake. I'm giving my life to God. For my family, for my sons, for my daughters. I'm giving my life. This morning, then you can come to the altar. You can rededicate your life this morning. I'm not going to pray for you. You can just rededicate your life. I challenge you this morning. Take a step out. Say, Lord, this morning, I'm coming to the altar. I'm ready to surrender my life. Hallelujah. We don't want anybody to move around. We want the Holy Ghost this morning. Are you desperate for Him this morning? And I'm desperate for you. Are
pastor said he's not going to pray for you. If you want to rededicate your life, if you want to reconsecrate your life, he says you can come and kneel in front here as a sign. Lord, I'm rededicating myself, Lord. Oh my, oh, and I, oh, I'm lost without you. Without you, and I, and I, I'm desperate for you. Without you, Lord, and I, he hears a desperate cry, he hears a cry, oh, I'm lost without you. This is the air I breathe. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Oh, your holy bread. Spoken, oh, to me. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence, oh, this morning, Lord. God, we're crying out this morning, Lord. Hallelujah. I'll cry, Lord. Come like thy Bartimaeus, Lord. Be like thy Bartimaeus this morning, Lord. Oh, God, you're passing by, Lord. Jesus, have mercy. Crying out, Lord. Crying out, Lord. Yeah, I'll cry, Lord. Yeah, I'll cry, Father. Yeah, I'll cry. Thank you. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. 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 So I'm here today because God kept me. I'm alive today because of His grace. So I'm here, so I'm here today, because God kept me. I'm alive today, only because of His grace.
Oh.
You know, as that song was being sung, the words for me were so powerful. And it exposes many times, especially times like this, when we see God moving, the enemy can also come, and he moves and he lies to you. The words of the song says, I was at the edge of a breakthrough, but I couldn't see it. Many times the Lord moves in the way he moves, and we're right there, right at the edge of that breakthrough. But we just caught, the breakthrough is staring us in the face. But I can't see it. All God wants from us is to just that extra push. Just a breakthrough. What the enemy comes, he lies to us. Sometimes even Brother Branham comes and gives us an example of somebody that needed to have that breakthrough. And Brother Branham says he prayed with this woman. She was on her knees. She prayed with him. She cried a little bit. And she said, Brother Branham, this is it. I've had my breakthrough. But Brother Branham, being Brother Branham, he's seen that this woman, she did not have her breakthrough. She did not have her deliverance. And he told her, sister, pray again. And then she prayed again. She went that little bit further. Her breakthrough was staring her in the face. But she had stopped just before that. Brother Branham see it, and he said, my sister, pray some more. And when this sister prayed some more, Brother Branham says, then she broke through. There might be somebody here in this meeting right now. Maybe you've cried. And you felt a little bit of emotion, which is good. But you know right now, you know within your heart right now, that you know what? I didn't really have a breakthrough with God. I cried. I got emotional. But I know within myself, I didn't break through to Him. The Lord just laid on my heart right now to let you know. You can break through. You can receive a total, total, total deliverance. I personally am so sick and tired. We have meetings like this. We come to the altar, we cry. But then we leave. And we just get out of this door. Then the enemy just trips us over. And we just fall back into the same rut again. The Lord just laid on my heart to let you know, believers, you can grab a genuine hold of Him today. And when you leave this place, you'll be totally free. When Malachi leaves this church, that door demon will never come back to him again. But he wants you to break through. Jesus.
God, just to move for a few moments. So every head bowed, every eye closed. Let the music play softly. I'm just going to allow God just to move. This is your day. Like Brother Tam will say, just go that extra mile. The devil is telling you, tired. The devil may be telling you, it's too late for you. Let God just move. I believe God wants to do something for God's people. Stand to our feet. We're going to close. Stand to your feet. Make this your declaration. Raise your hand. If this is your testimony, make this your testimony. Let's make this our declaration. Let's make this our announcement this morning. I'm no longer. And I don't care what it looks like. What it looks like. This is our declaration. I'm no longer a slave. This is our declaration. Come on, young people. This is our declaration. Raise your hands. Our declaration. I'm no longer. September, we went free. We are free from man's opinions. We are free from man's ideas. We are free what man thinks. We are free from circumstances. We are free from complexes. We are free from complexes. We are free from the world. We are free this morning. Don't care what it looks like. We are free. No longer a slave to fear. I am. That's right. I'm no longer.
is our song on the 3rd of September. My declaration. Is there any young brother or young sister wants to come stand by me and make that your declaration? Come stand with me and we'll let the world know. Brother Stewart, you put this on camera and you let the world know. This is our declaration. Whether we feel it or whether we are it, this is our declaration. These young people, now you sing it this morning. Sing it this morning. I'm no longer. Our declaration. We are free.
Making a declaration this morning. Satan, I want you to have a look at this. I want you to have a look at this morning, devil. These are young people here this morning. They are no longer. They are telling you this morning. They are no longer a slave. They are declaring this morning, I'm no longer, I am no longer. Hallelujah. I'm a child of God. I'm no longer. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Ralph, can you pray for us? I know you were going to greet the church, but brother, the Spirit of God just changed things.
Heavenly Father, just thank you, Lord God. And I believe the service now is under your hand, Lord God. You're taking control, Lord God. You see the needs of the people. Lord God, you have placed you on their throne, Lord God. Lord, devil had us bound, Lord God. And Lord God, as Moses said unto the children of Israel, the Egyptians you see today, you no longer see them no more. Why? Because of the salvation, the power of the Holy Ghost is moving. And Lord God, as the spiritual Israel today, Lord God, your bride, Lord Father, they can say the Egyptians, the devil, no longer, you no longer exist anymore. So we thank you, Lord God. Oh, your almighty power, Lord God. Oh, we see you moving in the church, Lord God. We see them moving in the homes, Lord God. So, Father God, we thank you, Lord Jesus. We appreciate you, Lord God. And we thank you, Lord Father, under the anointing of the Holy Spirit right now, flowing through every hand. Every hand raised, young and old, Lord God. So we thank you, Jesus. I just thank you, Lord God, for making a way for me to be here with the brethren, Lord God. And I just appreciate you, Lord God. Lord, if we leave our life in your hands, Lord God, we leave it in man's hand, Lord God, we're going to fail. But Lord God, your hands never fail, Lord God. You have the promise, Lord God. Every man makes a promise and fails and never comes to pass. But Lord God, when you make a promise, Lord God, Lord, you said unto Abraham, go before me. Hallelujah. And be thou perfect. Lord, the world today see us not perfect.
But God, you see yourself in us, Lord God. That's the perfection, Lord God. Hallelujah. We come from you. We're going back to you, Lord God. So we thank you, Jesus. We appreciate, Lord God. Thank you once again, Lord Father. Let the needs be met, Lord God, today. Lord, we pray. We thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Let the weak say, I am. Let the poor say, I am.
That's your testimony this morning.
Say, I can see. It's what the Lord has done.
That's why you are free this morning. Hosanna,
Hosanna to the Lamb that was slain. Hosanna, Hosanna, Jesus died.
Oh, let's sing it again now. Hosanna.
Bless your church. You may be seated. Thank you this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh my. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We just want to pray for the offering of tithes. We'll be taking it up right now. Father, we thank you this morning. This tremendous time. Lord, you took this meeting over this morning. And this is my prayer, Lord. Not just another meeting. Not just me, some man standing here and ministering. But the Holy Ghost taking over. And you did that, Father. We want to say thank you this morning. Pray for Brother Ralph. He'll be going back tonight. So glad we could have had him here for this time. To have seen, Lord God, reality that God is amongst your people. Pray for him as he journeys back home, Lord. Might your presence be with him, with his family, and everyone else that's been, Lord God, on the internet watching us. Might they also be blessed and challenged as they saw and they heard and they saw the waters being stirred this morning. And I believe somewhere on the internet, wherever they've been, they have also jumped in. And they have received their portion this morning. Now, Lord, we pray for the tithes and the offering as your people will give. Might you bless them. And those who can't give, Lord, might you even bless them that they might give next time. We commit them now and bless the tithes and the offerings. In the precious name of Jesus Christ. Might you go with your people, Lord God. By the anointing, follow them. Go into our homes.
wherever we might be, might this anointing be with us. We want to say thank you this morning in Jesus' precious name. Thank you. Hallelujah. God bless you, church. God bless you this morning. Hallelujah. Take the name of Jesus with you. We'll be back here on Tuesday evening. And we believe we're going to have a blessed and a wonderful time. So pray for one another. Love one another. Greet one another. Don't leave the church if you haven't greeted me. May God richly bless you. Amen. Amen. God bless you.
You're my brother, you're my sister.